In this tutorial, we're managing mismatched media in DaVinci Resolve. My timeline resolution today is 3840 by 2160. Please note, this often gets mistaken as 4K. However, it is not. This is UHD, ultra high definition. We'll start by adding a UHD clip to my timeline. I can confirm that it is a UHD clip with the metadata tab. You can see the resolution listed here. As expected, because the resolution is a perfect match, the image fills the frame perfectly. Let's look at the second clip. The metadata tab tells me that it is only 1920 by 1080. That's HD. However, when I add it to the timeline, it too fills the frame. Why is that? Because by default, Resolve is configured to scale mismatched resolution clips to fit the frame. The setting that controls this behavior is in Project Settings, in the Image Scaling tab. You can see it's set to Scale Entire Image to Fit. The next clip we're going to add has an unusual resolution. Many professional cinema cameras shoot natively in non-standard resolutions. When the entire sensor is captured, we typically call that open gate. This is an open gate shot. Let's see what happens when I add this to my timeline. This clip is pillar boxed. It has two vertical bars on either side of it. Unlike my previous clip, it has not been scaled to fill the viewer. There's two reasons for that. Firstly, this clip does not have the same resolution as my timeline. My previous two clips did. And secondly, remember, Resolve's default setting is to fit an image to the viewer, which it has. However, you can override this behavior on a clip-by-clip basis within the inspector. Select the clip, scroll to the bottom of the inspector. At the moment, scaling is set to project settings. That means it does whatever it has been configured to do by default. For right now, I'll change scaling to fill. Voila! Now the image fills the viewer. I can change what part of the image is seen with the position controls. It's great to know that clips can be configured individually, but it will get tedious if multiple clips need adjusting. Let's put scaling back to project settings and configure this setting globally. Head back to project settings and let's change the behavior for mismatched resolution files to scale full frame with crop. That's another way of saying fill, and hit save. Now, not only has this fixed the clip I already placed in the timeline, but any subsequent clips with mismatched resolution that I insert into my timeline will also be scaled to fill the image. Now, moving on to our final clip. This has been shot in a wider scope aspect ratio, but it's still automatically scaled to fill the frame. And like before, I can reframe the image using the position controls in the inspector. I'll reposition this image so I can see the dancer even better. If this technique is new to you, you may want to investigate the other options in the scaling drop-down menus. Fill or scale full frame to crop I find to be most helpful and also fit. But there might be other scenarios when using stretch or crop are useful for you too. So have fun checking them out. In review, if you're working on a project that contains media of varying resolutions, not to worry. Resolve makes it incredibly easy to handle mismatched resolutions within your timeline. If you enjoyed today's tutorial, give it a like and subscribe for more.